Welcome back, everyone. In this video, we will discuss specific steps you will need to complete the clock reaction experiment, as well as any safety and waste disposal information. As I discussed in the previous two videos in the sequence, there are three parts to today's experiment. In all of the experiments, however, you will follow the steps described next. First, use a graduated cylinder to get approximately 100 milliliter of each of the reagents. Potassium iodide, potassium bromate, HCl, and sodium thiosulfate, and put them in separate beakers. All these reagents will be found in reagent bottles stored inside the fume hood. Once you have the reagents on your bench, you will do the following steps for each of the trial you will perform. 1. You will prepare two flasks. In the first flask, which is called flask 1 in your lab procedure, you will mix water, potassium iodide, and sodium thiosulfate. In the other flask, called flask 2, you will mix potassium bromate, HCl, and starch. The reaction starts when you pour the content of flask 2 into flask 1. So before you mix the content of the two flasks, make sure you have a timer ready. As soon as the content of flask 2 touches the content of flask 1, the timer must be started. The timer is stopped as soon as the blue color appears. Don't wait until the solution is dark blue. Once you record the time, put a thermometer inside the flask to measure the temperature of the reaction. The exact volumes that you must mix in flask 1 and 2 are given in table 1 and in the instructions in parts B and C in your lab procedure. For part B specifically, where you will measure rate as a function of temperature, you will need to use 3 water baths to equilibrate the reaction's temperature. 2 of these are warm water baths and 1 is an ice water bath as shown on the screen. Typically, 1 warm bath is set around 30 degrees Celsius and another around 40 degrees Celsius. For these, place your flask 1 and 2 in the water bath for about 3 minutes as shown in the picture. Then, mix the content of the two flasks and record the time when the blue color appears. The mixing is done at room temperature. Lastly, measure the temperature of the content with a thermometer, just like you did with the previous trials. Make sure the temperature is measured right after you stop the timer. For the ice bath, the procedure is similar, except that you will leave the flasks in the ice bath for about 10 minutes before mixing. Again, once you mix, you can continue mixing at room temperature and only stop when the blue color appears. At that point, you can measure the temperature of the mixture, and it might be 3 degrees or 5 degrees, and that would be the temperature you would write in your lab report. Note that you want to record the actual temperature value you measure in your lab report, and not the temperature value of the water bath you used. Once you collect all your data, show them to your instructor to check if they are reasonable. Now, let me talk a little bit about waste disposal. Once you record the time and temperature for each trial, you can discard the mixture in the sink. The only mixture that must be discarded into the chemical waste container is the mixture containing the catalyst, which is in part C. You'll need your goggles, lab coat, gloves, and closed-toe shoes for this experiment. This concludes the clock reaction experiment video. We will discuss any questions you have when we meet in lab.